Hi guys, Codetutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande. In the previous video, we have seen how to create a broadcast receiver and declare it in a manifest file so that it can listen to an incoming SMS. Declaring a broadcast receiver in the manifest file would work in the most of the situation, but in certain scenarios, this is not an appropriate solution. For example, assume that you have an app. That app needs to read one-time password that is being sent from the backend. And this one-time password, when it is received, my broadcast receiver will read it and will be able to recognize the incoming one-time password. But if my app is not in the foreground, in spite of that, my app will receive this particular OTP because it is declared in the manifest file, which is wrong. Instead of declaring it in the manifest file, we have to declare the broadcast receiver in the code. So let us see this in a demo. What I will do first is, whatever the declaration that I had here in the manifest file, I will remove it. So I will just comment this out. This is not necessary. But what I will do is, I will register this particular broadcast receiver through the code. For that, let me go back to the activity. I have an instance of a broadcast receiver. This needs to be initialized. Broadcast receiver is equal to new my broadcast receiver. My broadcast receiver is initialized, and now I need to register it. Now, where do I register this? OnStart gets triggered when you start an activity, and OnStop gets triggered when the application is going back to the background. If the registration needs to happen, it needs to happen in the onStart method of the activity lifecycle, and the unregistration should happen in the onPause method of the activities lifecycle. So let me do that. Register receiver, broadcast receiver.
The second parameter is the intent filter. So let me create an intent filter. That is created by intent filter is equal to new intent filter. And the value that I need to pass is the action tag that I had used while registering it in the manifest file.
And let me pass that particular intent filter here. And I will unregister this in the onTop method. So unregister the initialized broadcast receiver. And now let me run this particular code. So my app has started with the onStart. Broadcast receiver has got registered. If I send the SMS now, it should be able to recognize the incoming SMS. So you can see that the toast message is there. And if I close this and if I send the message, you won't see that particular toast message. So this is how you can dynamically register and unregister a broadcast receiver to better suit your requirement.
That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.